You made flat ballet shoes, you customized your shoe last, what is next?
Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses.
In this tutorial, I will show you what is the right order of learning in shoemaking to get best results. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's start. What's next? Next is to make flat ballet shoes with fabric. Many of you will want to create flat ballet shoes with fabric or with semi-leather or with combination of many other different materials. The trick is here to use what you already made and adjust it according to the quality of materials or to the designs that you want to make. For example, to create this flat ballet shoes, I used this fabric and this patent leather, but you will be able to use here any other type of fabric or semi-leather, or even you can create entire shoe from fabric, from denim. Also, when you will know how to adjust existing pattern, you will know how to create whatever you want. For example, I made here this line like this. You can create here straight line. You can add here straps. You can make here any other design of the counter, make it straight, shorter, longer, whatever you want. How it works? You take the pattern that you already made, the basic pattern. Then you see this is part from this pattern we made the simple flat ballet shoes. Then we adjust it to the fabric. We need to add extra seam allowance and to the design that we want to create. For example, here I have this line, you see the rounded one, and on the back part line like this. But again, here you will create your design and you will know how to do it. This is actually the main purpose of this approach. This is your foundation to create whatever you want. And using this approach, you will be able to create any design of boots, Oxford shoes, moccasins, sandals, whatever you want. This is how I work when I create collections for my clients, for factories. I design many different footwear designs and I don't create pattern for each of them separately. I took one solid good pattern and adjust it to the materials that I will use in this footwear or to the designs that I want to incorporate inside of this solid pattern. This is how I work. This is how you should know to create endless designs. To build your foundation and to get freedom in making any footwear type, next step is to learn these two footwear types, Oxford shoes and derby shoes. Why is that? Now I will reveal you the secret. The fact is that shoes with laces are constructed on these two types. It constructed on Oxford shoes or on derby shoes. That means that if you will want to create high boots, boots with low tops, or sneakers with high top or low top, this is what you need to know, how to construct Oxford shoes or how to construct derby shoes. Let's take pattern of Oxford shoes. This is the basic pattern and this all other type parts of the upper. When you will know how to construct the quarters and the vamp and the tongue of the Oxford shoes, you will be able to incorporate this construction in the making of boots, for example. Let's say you will want to create boots based on Oxford construction. So you will already know how to find the laces here, how to design them, how to construct them, etc. Here we'll have laces. It could be with the design like on the Oxford shoes. It could be also with a simple toe cap, with the extra details here and here, whatever you want. Same thing with the derby shoes. When you will know the construction of these derby shoes, where we have here opened quarters, you will be able to design and create, for example, sneakers. Let's make a sneakers, that design sneakers with high top. Here the sole isn't important. What is important is the construction. You see, here we have quarters based on the quarters of derby shoes. So when you will know how to construct this Oxford shoes, here for example, another detail or many other details you will want to incorporate inside of these sneakers, you will know how to do it, because even the construction of this part of our sneakers based on the construction of these classic derby shoes. Do you understand what does it mean for you? It means that when you will know the construction of these two classic footwear types, you will know how to design, how to create any footwear type with laces. That's it. Now I want to focus on these derby shoes. Why is it important? These derby shoes is bespoke shoes. Bespoke means that it created according to the measurement of the foot. You remember the previous video where I showed you why we need to customize standard shoe last? So here I explain how to customize shoe last and change its shape with the bag done leather. Next thing is what is important here is that we have here the bespoke insole. This insole is molded on the custom made shoe last with extra support, and it gives to this footwear extra comfort. It gives a support to the arc zone. Also, we used here natural materials, so entire shoes is built from natural materials without any chemical materials. What I mean that inside of this footwear, between upper and lining, we placed leather counters, the toe puff and the counter. Also, the shoe sole made from leather and it's stitched by hand to the upper and insole. Shoemaking tools and materials. I already made few tutorials about different shoemaking tools and materials and how to work with them. So I will leave links to these tutorials in the description below this video. What I want to talk with you about shoemaking tools and materials that are essential for you to start making shoes right away. You know, there are a lot of different shoemaking tools and materials that shoemakers use, but for you as a beginner in shoemaking, it will not help, because you don't know how to work with them and you will be disappointed because you will not get any results. That's why these essential tools are important for you. On the other hand, there are a lot of tools like DIY tools that is non-correct to work with. For example, you know this potato peeler that many uses to skive leather, but it's ridiculous, because to skive leather and make beautiful and comfortable shoes, you should work with this professional shoemaker knife. So what we have here? We have here shoe last. We have here many different cardboards, texan board, shank board to create insole. Also the cork to create a beautiful bottom of lasted shoes. This material, chemical material to use in making counters, the toe puff, the back counter, but instead of this material you also can use leather, and I talked about this natural material in bespoke shoemaking when I showed you the derby and why we need to learn it. Now the hammer, shoemaking hammer that we use in many different operations to attach the insole, to attach the sole, to create heel, to fold upper and lining as well. These professional pincers, only with this tool is correct to last shoes, not with your hand. I repeat it again and again, don't use your hand to create shoes. Use professional shoes to get best results, to get beautiful shoes and not damage your hands. The rasp, it has two different girths, many different surfaces to work with in few different steps. The tapes, reinforcement tapes to reinforce your upper in many different parts. Thread, polyester thread. I suggest to use polyester thread number 60. Nails, short nails, long nails. Steel shanks that we place in any footwear type to have very comfortable shoes that will support our arc zone. Tape, measurement tape, silver pen. So this is 17 shoemaking tools that are essential for you to start making shoes right away. And if you want, I will leave a link below this video with the full list of these tools that you can download and have it close to you. So that's it. There are other three things that you also need to have. This is leather or fabric. It depends from which material you want to make your shoes. Contact glue for leather and sewing machine. You don't need to invest your money by buying new industrial heavy duty machine. You can find some second hand sewing machine, or even as a beginners just starting making your shoes, you can stitch all your upper and lining by hand. This is how made few of my students, they started with hand stitching. Okay, so that's it for this tutorial. If you have questions, please comment below, and in the next tutorial I will show you what else is very important for you as a beginner to know about shoemaking and making your shoes. So thank you and see you next time. Bye.